we have had the worst January ever. And I don't want to be too overdramatic. Sometimes I get that way. Well, ever since this, and what happened on that day? Well, here, I will show you. Truman announces development of the H-bomb. So the Nasdaq poised for the worst January ever. Bitcoin, the worst start of the year ever. And these are the cheapest the stocks have been since 2020. And just in case you wanted to buy that said dip, well, we got a couple people that are snatching it all up. And cue the fire, that would be Bill Ackman and Cathie Woods just snapping up all the good deals that are on sale. And almost 50 years ago today, we had people running to the moon, just like what we do now. We have talks of war, just like we do now. We have stock market crashes, just like we do now. But I need to help you because we keep repeating these same things. I know it's not breaking news, but if you could throw me a life preserver, that would be you clicking the like button. For some reason, it helps save the channel. Just click a lot. Also, you guys were asking me about the Bitcoin. I will tell you what's going on. Look at that correlation between the dollar and Bitcoin. Always that negative. Kind of like some of you are like, Bravo, why are you so negative? Well, okay, NASDAQ poised for the worst January. We did it in 50 years of existence. I would say that's negative. I also drew a toilet bowl and the stock market. Okay, so here we go. And if you're wondering what all those these dots are on here, that's me because I always pee all over the toilet seat. Apologize. Apologies, ladies. You want me to put my hand in that stuff? But anyway, so here, you're like, oh my gosh, we had a bounce today. But at the end of the day, right? Where's it all going? And actually, if I was to trade this, that's probably much a falling wedge, right? Are we getting that? Ah, look. Look, it's going to make the break. I cannot believe I'm doing this with currents. About that size. That's where you want to sell. And also, be careful of my squigglies here. That's a double top. Also, this is clearly a lower high, right? What happens after lower high goes right into the toilet. But despite gains from Monday, today we got the bounce. Woo, so exciting. Also, in bear markets, you have the biggest swing trade opportunities in the history of mankind. But if you would like to see what it kind of looks like, if you're a chart guy, if you like big black lines that protrude out, here, NASDAQ on track. Worst, you can't say it yet. We're not done with January. So here we are. We got the big, fat, black one right there. And they're all just sitting here staring at me. And then, what should I do, Jimmy?
Buy, buy, buy.
Yes, we will buy. And the NASDAQ 100 is the cheapest since May 2020. After a price drop it like it's hot, you have a earnings pop. Poof. Also known as a probability of a dead cat bounce. But that's okay. We want those reversals. Kind of like what's happening here on Bitcoin. You see that? That drop and then pop above. That would be your swing trade. But then again, on closer inspection on Bitcoin, you have a rising wedge. Oh no. And what do we do with rising wedges? Well, or wedgies that I have in the course, what happens is they break down. So do not catch yourself on the wrong side of this trade. And also enroll in course for discount code below. So even with Bill and Cathie all buying the dips, you guys can have knowledge and go, wait a minute, I know how to trade this. Because they don't always tell you the truth. Or they'll be on one side when you're on the other. And they're like, ah, gotcha, made a $1 billion more. That's why you subscribe to this channel, because I teach you this stuff. So when these guys talk, you're like, oh, I don't listen to you. But these guys are full force. What do you got to lose when half of you, what is ARK Invest down? 60%? Bill Ackman, they're like, whatever, all in. Bill Ackman, Cathie Wood lead the charge back into tech stocks as the sell-off attracts dip buyers. And I say dip buyers are always going to be dip buyers. You're going to need some chips because you're going to have way more dips than you have chips. Also, if you want to know a little bit more detail of what's going on with the Bitcoin, so you got the rising wedge. Oh, that's going to break. It's probably going to hit its head right on that blue line. See that? That blue line right there. I can actually turn it yellow. It's a 20. When should you have bought the dip? See those green things all in the course? Teach you how to turn everything if you want to be the dip buyer. And I'll tell you, these channels right here have been so good at predicting Bitcoin. And also, let me just move it to Heikinashi so you can kind of just see. And you see that sell that came on way back there? Man, that could have saved you a lot on car insurance. And actually, look at the weekly. If you're like, oh, well, I mean, it's those little indicators that my finger goes into right there. That's lose a finger. It's still it's trending down. And we're actually getting ready to put in another red candle on the monthly. I know this isn't breaking news, but let's just make it breaking news. I mean, if you want to buy this, you can buy it. But Bitcoin January, there is a thing called a crypto winter. Worst start of year since crypto winter. Well, didn't we already do the four-year cycle? Huh? I think we did. Or, there's a clue, right? Come on, you guys, don't get all tricked by their Bybit links in S&P 500. Bounces. Oh my gosh. We have bounces. Second day as it wraps up the worst, the worst month, not even day. Nasdaq jumps 2.5. So boom, chakalaka, pop the confetti. And if you guys could, in the comments section, let me know. Are you guys buying the dip? Are you trading? Just kind of curious. And I'll see you in the next video.